Welcome back to Animals Committing Suicide. This is part 3 though. Last episode had a lack of fungi. To be honest, they're fucked when it comes to this shit. Their lives are short and sweet, and they're mostly fed shit and kept in the dark, so naturally they want to die. As you can see, they grow up quick, they're into peer pressure and fucking around with each other, so naturally depression comes to them. Number one drops dead, two follows, three is like, fuck it, I'm going to break my neck now, and crunch. The rest of them follow the script and drop dead. Vermine are perceived as disease-ridden creatures, so it would come as no surprise when one decides to fling himself off a balcony. I agree, this was a bit of a shit clip. Nobody really cares about rats, just ask the Middle Ages. They come into your life and bring all sorts of shit. Here we have Kazza the Kestrel, a good sportsman in the animal society. Recently, he hasn't been doing too good with his track records, and some younger Kestrels have come in, and he's been knocked down a couple of notches. And well, in Kestrel society, it's better to go out with a bang rather than fade away. Here we have a domestic dispute between a frog and a man... woman thing. It seems to be a disagreement between the color of this flower. I think someone reckons it's purple maybe. And no, the frog's like, it's red, trust me. I'm good at telling colors. He gives a cheeky wink at the camera, and the human loses his, her shit, and pins up the frog against the wall, smacking it repeatedly. The cameraman is clearly disgusted by this. The human continues to show its rage against a chair, and then tells the frog it's going for a walk, and by the time it arrives back home, it should be fucking suicided or something to give this video content. Ooh, man, that really hurt. To be honest, I'm feeling a little bit depressed now. Video 3 in the sub-series. I know what this poor frog fellow here is going through.
Kermit swinging like Tarzan, mashup of the century!
This is Rodney the Raccoon. He's in a bit of a predicament, and the humans are trying to help, and ooh, it's a long way down. I think we all know what's going to happen. One wrong move and Rodney slips. But wait, what's this? A divine intervention has kicked in, and God himself has reached down his glorious godlike hands and has cupped Rodney and is lifting him away to safety. It's that or the ginger in frame has some fucking muju voodoo shit going on. Well, long story short, Rodney here is lifted off to safety, a lovely pasture somewhere in somewhereness, and is left there to live out the rest of his days in peace and tranquility. And if you haven't noticed by now, this indeed is the bonus clip.
Dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold.